The urgency of climate change is real. Think about the floods in Western Europe and the heat records all around the world. The rapid pace of natural disasters have shown us that we rely on nature more than anything else. Driving electric cars or shopping more local goods are some of the concrete climate actions that many people have heard of, are luckily already living by. Today, I will advocate for something different, something powered by nature itself. Over many years, many of us have been taught that a good bacteria was a dead bacteria. But what if I told you that that couldn't be more wrong? That those microbes can actually help address a major challenge, such as climate change. Thanks to science, we know that almost everything on this planet is made from tiny microbes, and that many of them are good for us. Bacteria are one of the most successful life forms on Earth. They have been around longer than humans and can adapt to extreme environments like living inside active hot springs. There are more bacteria than grains of sand. Even you carry around 40 trillion bacteria in and on your body. Think about it. We live in their world, not the other way around. Now, just a minute ago, I boldly stated that good bacteria can help fight climate change. At this point in history, I personally cannot think of a challenge more profound. The conclusion from the most recent IPCC report is alarming. We're facing a code red for humanity. Business as usual or having a well-intentioned plan B is no longer enough, because there's no planet B for us to call our home. There is still hope, but it requires a willingness to transform. So what if we started looking to nature for answers and truly unleashed the power of good bacteria? I promise you that the potential is not only huge, but also surprisingly relatable for anybody who hates wasting food or who loves a tasty burger. I work as a director of sustainability at a global Danish bioscience company called Christian Hansen. Not everyone is familiar with our name, but many of you know our taste. More than 1 billion people consume food or health products every day that contains our natural ingredient. We specialize in fermentation and microbial science. All right, it's time to be concrete and explore how these tiny micro warriors can help us fight climate change. As a first example, let's talk food waste. Here are some fast facts to stage the issue. The food and agricultural industries account for approximately 1/3 of all greenhouse gas emissions. Around 1/3 of all food is wasted. And the unnerving truth is that 8 to 10% of greenhouse gases are associated with food that is never consumed. These facts demonstrate both the magnitude of the problem and the urgent need to rethink our food system. The problem only seems bigger when considering that in 2050, we will be 10 billion people on this planet. We simply need to address this unbearable amount of waste. As consumers, we've all tried opening the fridge to find food that's gone bad, whether it's moldy sour cream or spoiled white cheese. In dairy, it's estimated that 17% of all yogurt in Europe is wasted. 81% of this is due to the expiration date. But with our lactic acid bacteria, we can help food producers keep their products fresh and safe for longer, simply because the good bacteria help to naturally inhibit the development of yeast and mold. So if these food cultures were used in Europe, in yogurts all over Europe, we could reduce that waste by 30% each year. And why do you think this matters from a climate perspective? Well, it does, because preventing food waste is a great way to lower our carbon footprint. And it's easy. Let me move on to my second example. And this is the place where a tasty burger takes a spotlight. When the pandemic hit last year, restaurants all over the world were closed overnight. That was also the case for Copenhagen's world-famous restaurant, Noma. Eating food prepared by Michelin chefs are, under normal circumstances, not a privilege for the masses. But that was about to change with the opening of an outdoor new burger joint. Well, you might be thinking that a good burger has always been a crowd pleaser. So why this example? Well, when the Copenhageners were queuing up for hours at this new spot, they were queuing up for a vegan burger. Now that's more unusual. Even so, this particular burger has been described by many as a masterpiece and as the best burger they've ever eaten. The secret? Well, by applying the art of fermentation, Noma demonstrated that the plant-based food can go mainstream if only taste and texture match the traditional food that we love. And that's also exactly what we're working on together with our customers and in partnerships to advance every day. And the mass aspect is important for a very obvious reason. We all need to eat a lot more vegetables if we are to create a more sustainable food system. I'm excited about this because the vegan burger brilliantly showcases how good bacteria can bring about real change in eating habits. It's therefore my hope that within the next decade, good bacteria will be recognized as the invisible master chefs that enabled a plant-based revolution. So it's clear that we cannot win the climate battle with the weapons of the past. That's especially true when it comes to agriculture. With a growing world population, the pressure on our food system is getting more and more intense. Food production will need to increase by 50%, something which requires an area 2 times the size of India. And with the added challenges of climate change, it's clear that the way we farm today will need to become significantly more sustainable. What we need is a regenerative agricultural system, a system that does more good than bad. I hope you're no longer surprised when I tell you that good bacteria can be an important part of the solution. Plants and bacteria have coexisted for millions of years, and they enjoy an extremely beneficial symbiosis. One family of bacteria that has proven to boost plant health are the bacillus microbes. So our bacterial solutions can deliver a yield that matches chemical alternatives. And as a part of the natural plant microbiome, they can help protect the crops against pests, disease, or flooding. Biological plant protection currently only represent 5% of the global market. And the conversion is not happening quite at the speed we need. In the EU, for example, it takes 5 to 8 years to get a product approved. Looking to climate science, we can immediately conclude that there is no time to waste. We cannot sit around harvest after harvest and wait. We desperately need to fast-track approvals of green solutions. Bacteria are the smallest creatures on this planet, yet so powerful. So let's use good bacteria in fermentation to prevent food waste, to indulge in more goodness from the plant kingdom, and to transform the way we farm by using natural plant protection. Let's celebrate good bacteria. They were here before the dinosaurs, and they will be here as long as we have a beautiful planet Earth. I believe that we have a lot to learn from them. Let us partner up with good bacteria to fight climate change. Thank you.